Another great episode of the Seven Deadly Sins, so let's get right to it. What up YouTube, it's your boy Anime Specialist. So we started where we left off in the last episode of the Seven Deadly Sins in the backstory of Ben. So far in this season of the Seven Deadly Sins, we've seen the backstory of Meliodas, we've seen the backstory of Dreyfus, and we've seen the backstory of Diane. So now it's time to talk about the backstory of Ben. Spoiler alert, the guy that taught Ben how to steal was indeed the wild fox that we saw in the last episode. I'll talk about the backstory quickly. So the guy that taught Ben how to steal had a choice. So he had to choose between Ben and his real son, because his real son was getting attacked by soldiers and Ben was getting attacked by other soldiers because Ben was trying to steal a treasure from somewhere. And he chose his blood son, the werefox. I understand why he would choose his blood son, because one, he's known his son since he was born, and two, they're blood related, so it kind of made sense. But it was a pretty generic backstory. We've seen this kind of backstory in other anime or movies, but it was still interesting the way they did it, because now Ben is an adult and the other guy is an old man, and they talked about it and it seems like they're okay. Then we go back to the Seven Deadly Sins. They're going to train, but King doesn't want to train because of Hendrickson. He still won't forgive him, and I understand that, but like Meliodas said, maybe King needs to be a little more flexible, because it wasn't all Hendrickson when he attacked Leonis. We saw some of the training and it was pretty interesting, because their weapon was their own magic and a tree branch that was embedded with magic. Some of the characters got new abilities and power. One of them got a like armor of electricity. I don't know if it will be effective against the demons, but we'll see. Except for the first duo that we saw training, we didn't see the other duos get some new abilities. I guess we'll see that in the next few episodes. But the other duo were Gaultier and King Arthur. That was an interesting combination. Maybe we'll see these two fight together against the Ten Commandments. And then the final duo that we saw go into training was King and Meliodas. But there was an interesting plot that happened. It started with Meliodas saying to King that maybe he needs to be more flexible around Hendrickson, because Hendrickson was controlled by one of the Ten Commandments. But because of that, King asked a lot of questions. He asked how does he know all the names of the Ten Commandments, and he asked Meliodas if he was part of the Demon Clan. And obviously we know that Meliodas is part of the Demon Clan, but the characters in the show, I don't think they all know. And because of that, it seems like King is gonna fight Meliodas in the next episode. The reason, in my opinion, that King is gonna fight Meliodas is because he doesn't trust him, because he's part of the same Demon Clan as the Ten Commandments. And as you all know, the Demon Clan attacked the Fairy Forest that King is protecting, and he's the king of the fairies, so he has reason for doubting Meliodas. I'm hype about what's gonna happen next in the Seven Deadly Sins. Obviously, I think Meliodas is more powerful than King, but there's something interesting that he said in the episodes. Meliodas said that he didn't get his power back. That I don't understand, because it seems like he passed his trial, so he should have his power back, but we'll see in the next episode or two. Let me know what you thought about this week's episode of the Seven Deadly Sins. I do Seven Deadly Sins review every Saturday, so subscribe for that. I do anime news and anime reviews every week, so like, comment, and subscribe for that. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Anime Specialist out. Peace.